Hi, and welcome to my blockchain tutorial. So maybe you're new to Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, and you're not quite sure where to start or how to buy your very first Bitcoin. What I'm going to do today is take you through the entire process of creating your very first wallet all the way through to buying your Bitcoin. Now, blockchain is one of the most popular wallets out there. There are other wallets available as well, such as Coinbase or Exodus. I've actually got tutorials of those as well. So if you'd like to have a look, then please look through the series of these videos. Now, I use blockchain as my very first Bitcoin buy wallet. So that's the reason why I've chosen this one. Also, the fact that you can purchase your Bitcoins through credits or debit cards is really helpful. So let's take us through that process now. So if you navigate to blockchain.info, please ensure that you put the exact address into here, maybe put it into your bookmarks, so that you're always ensuring that you're going to the same site. Now, like I said, blockchain is one of the most popular and well-trusted of wallets. Obviously, they're saying here they're that number one digital wallet. They've got 100 million transactions with 15 million wallets out there as well. So what we're going to do is go through and create our first wallet. Now, these wallets are obviously free as well. And in here, make sure that you put in quite a complex password so that is strong. And then go through and read the terms and conditions and then click on to continue. What it's now done is gone through and created that wallet for me, and it's given me an identifier as well. What I now need to do is verify my email. So I'm going to go to my Gmail account here and click onto this email. Now in here, you can see that I've got a wallet ID. Now this wallet ID is almost like a username that you would use to log into any kind of application, or almost like your kind of credentials. Now this is something that you need to keep personal to you. So please ensure that you have a copy of this wallet ID. Maybe print it off and put it into a safe, maybe put it into a password protected document, something like that anyway, and keep that personal to you. Now, obviously, this is just a test account that I'm using so I can show you my wallet ID, but just make sure you keep that personal. And obviously, go through and verify your email. Now that's done, I'll return back to my blockchain website. And I'm just going to exit out of that for the moment. What I'll do is I'll take you through the different options here on the left-hand side, and then we'll go through and show you how to buy your very first Bitcoin and all the different options in here as well. So what you have when you first go into blockchain is like a dashboard. So from here, you can send and receive Bitcoin or Ether. You can view your balances. You can view how the value is tracking. You can go through, and they also have a mobile app as well, which I find really helpful. One of the good things about the mobile app is that obviously you can use your own additional security like fingerprinting and things like that. And you've just got a nice little app that you can download if you wish. So blockchain allow you to have two different cryptocurrencies, which are Bitcoin and Ether. So you have two different wallets. So you have your Bitcoin wallet. So when you click on here, you can send and receive Bitcoin, and you can view any transactions that you may have made in here. And then you have Ether as well. So you can get started, have a look at your transactions again. You then have the option in here to buy and sell Bitcoin. Now we'll go through that shortly after I've gone through the different options. You then have an exchange. So in here, you're able to exchange from Bitcoin to Ether and Ether to Bitcoin. You then have your security center. So this is the section I'm going to go through first. Now we've already gone through and we have verified our email. So that's all good. Now the next thing you have is a backup recovery phase. Now this is really important. And the reason why this is important is purely for the fact that instead of, if for example, you lose your password or you can't remember it for any reason, there is no option for you to reset that password within blockchain. They don't store the passwords. So what you need to do is ensure that you have a backup recovery phase. So for any reason you can't remember your password or you can't remember your details, what you can do is revert back to this backup phrase. What it does, it provides you with a list of words. So I'll just take us through there. And it gives me some words. So it gives me sort of north, stairs, narrow, prevent, And what you should do with these words is you need to print them off. Again, you need to put them into a safe, or you need to put them into a password protected document or something along those lines, and have those so that they are safe to you. Obviously, you shouldn't share those. Again, this is for the purposes of this tutorial. I can show you those words, but you need to keep those words safe to yourself. You then have a password hint, so it's just additional help in case you've forgotten it. You then have the option of level 2 to prevent unauthorized access to your wallet. So you can link in a mobile phone in here, and what it will allow you to do is use like an authentication. So you can use an app such as Google Authenticator, which you can download from the App Store. And what it provides you with is like a one-time passcode, so that when you go to log into blockchain, you obviously put in your wallet ID, you put in your password, and then it'll provide you with a like a numeric number that will be available for 30 seconds. And you can enter that into the login script as well. So it's just really securing it and ensuring that, you know, it is you that is trying to log into your blockchain wallet. So you can go through and you can enable those steps in there as well. You then have an advanced level of security as well, where you can block Tor requests. If I now take us through to our settings. So in here, it provides me with my wallet ID. So this is the ID that we got provided to in our Gmail earlier on. So this is my unique wallet ID that is personal to me that I must not share with others. So this isn't the address that you use to send or receive Bitcoin or anything like that. It's purely your, you know, your credentials, so to speak. In here as well, you can pay your mobile phone, like I explained. You then have preferences. So in here, you can put in your mobile number. You can choose a wallet language. There's a lot of different languages within this section. Obviously, I'm English, so I'm keeping that to English. You can then choose your local currency. Again, I'm from the UK, so mine's currently set to GBP, but there's loads of different currencies in here that you can use. You then have Bitcoin units, so you can obviously choose from Bitcoin, Millibitcoin, or Bits. You then have notifications, so you can be notified via email or via SMS when you receive Bitcoin. You then have things like the auto logout. So this could be really important if, for example, you you know, you keep yourself logged in and you forget to sign out. What you need to do is you need to, you know, you can change the different period of time here, so it automatically logs you out and no one can nip onto your computer and start using it. Now, I personally would recommend clicking on the sign out button as soon as you're finished, but this will just give you kind of like an additional layer again and ensuring that you can, you know, obviously log out of this account. Now, if you are using a public computer, such as an internet cafe, or using someone else's computer, again, just make sure that you click on sign out, but you do have that additional layer of auto logout there as well. In terms of security, so this is where we have the wallet recovery phrase. So like I said, this is just in case you forget your password. You can change your password in here as well. You have your password hint. You've got a second wallet password. This is where you can enable that two-factor authentication with that one-time code as well. And you can have a remember in there as well. Then you have a addresses. So in here, you can manage different addresses. Say, for example, you wanted to categorize things within your Bitcoin wallet, and you wanted to say all my expenses, and you want to put all your categories in there as well, or everything that's receipts, everything that comes from a certain address. It just kind of, you are your own bank. So what you're essentially doing is just categorizing things and explaining, you know, what the different addresses are for. You've then got an FAQ section in here as well. So, you know, very simple questions being answered. If you've got any questions you want to ask me, please feel free. But this is in here as well, so it's just kind of helpful. So what I'm going to do now is go to buy our first Bitcoin. Now, before you go through and buy your first Bitcoin, it's always important that you verify all your information. So put in your mobile number. They might ask you for further verifications, such as your address, and where you're from and your date of birth and things like that. So just make sure that you go through all of those steps. So in here, you can see that if I type in an amount which is £100, it'll then give me my conversion into Bitcoin. What it also does, it tells me the current value of Bitcoin at the moment. Or I could choose whether or not I want to purchase in US dollars or euros and different types of options in here as well. If I then click on to buy Bitcoin, in here you have two different options. So like I said previously, the really good thing about blockchain is the fact that you can purchase Bitcoin using a credit or debit card or via bank transfer. Now, when I first bought my first Bitcoin, I made a little bit of an error. I thought, you know, I wanted to save a little bit of the fees that were being charged in here. So as you can see, credit cards have got a 3% fee and bank transfers got a 0.25% fee. So what I thought I'd do the first time round is save myself on the fees and choose bank transfer. Now, the one thing to be aware of here is if you go for bank transfer, like I have, you know, different banks vary. But however, from the UK, I actually got charged a £25 international fee. So instead of receiving a fee of, for example, 3%, so if I was looking at £100, I'd be looking at paying £3. Instead of paying £3, I actually paid £25. So just be a little bit wary of which option you choose in here. I quite like the convenience of the fact that you can use a credit or debit card in here as well. So I'm going to select that option and go to continue. So in here is a confirmation of your order. So it allows you to go through. You can edit it in here as well. It will tell you the amount of Bitcoin. It tells you your payment fee and your total cost. If you then click on to confirm. So what I then did was I put in my credit card details. Obviously, I didn't share those. And then I went through and confirmed that and then bought my first Bitcoin. So what I'm going to do now is show you how to receive Bitcoin from others. So if I click on to request, you can select the type of currency that you would like to receive. So whether or not that be Bitcoin or whether or not that be Ether. You're then provided with an address. So this is like a one-time address for this transaction. So I could copy this link and send it to the person that's sending me the cryptocurrency, or I can view the QR code in here as well. So if they've got a mobile app and they want to send me you know, a cryptocurrency, then what they can do is simply scan in that QR code. Or again, from this screen, you can simply click copy. It'll then state that it's copied. You can then send that across to them. If you then like to send Bitcoin or Ether, of course, you can obviously select again. You select the type of currency and then you put in the destination address. So you would either put in an address or a destination. Anytime that you're putting in an address or a destination, you really need to make sure that you make sure that it is exactly correct. So check every single letter, check the beginning, check the end, make sure it's exactly right. Because once you've sent that Bitcoin, it's gone. But you can also use that QR code again in here as well, if you so wish. Keeps it a little bit more secure, but it depends on, you know, where you're sending to and whether or not you have that available or not. If I now choose to send a certain amount, for example, if I put in $5 here, again, it does that conversion for me. And then it allows me to put in a description. So I could put in a description in here to the person that I'm sending it to. And then it will obviously give it a description. So it's just, like I said, we're our own bank. We're just categorizing, we're putting descriptions in here just so we can track things through the wallet. We then have an option in here for the transaction fee. So you have an option to go regular, which is, they say the current confirmation time is 1 hour plus. Or you can go priority, where it will do it under an hour. Now, I tend to find I mostly use the regular system, purely for the fact that it normally happens under an hour anyway. But, you know, it's up to you whichever you choose. And obviously, you know, you've got the rates and how much you're actually going to be charged for this as well. If I now click on to continue, it would then take me through the process of sending that Bitcoin and it would send that for us. So that was my blockchain tutorial. I hope that you found it useful. If you're interested in seeing more from this series, then please hit subscribe. There's a few other tutorials in there as well that you may be interested in, such as Coinbase or Exodus. If you liked it, then please give me a like, or if you have any comments, please put them below. Thanks, and I'll see you soon.